Yo, Seb, how's it going?
Yeah, not bad. Can you hear me?
Yep.
We're good?
Excellent.
Cool. So, who's playing?
Oh, Batman Fresh.
We've got Batman Fresh versus Rubes, I believe.
Who does Rubes play?
Lily.
Lily? That's
yeah.
Player, not common.
Quite rare these days, anyway. You're a bit quiet, Seb. If you can do anything to turn the volume up a bit.
I can turn the volume up. I'm not really going to be speaking too loud.
There you go.
Yeah, this is better because I'm out in the PlayStation menu. For some reason, that's much better.
Ah, okay.
So while inside you're like, watching the game, then it goes lower and crappier for some reason.
That's weird.
Let's see if there's anything I can do that. Chat audio. Maybe I should press prioritize game chat.
Ah, possibly. But then would that mute out the party chat?
No. That didn't work. Always love. Main rate for share play. What about now?
Yeah, it doesn't sound too bad. As long as the stream can hear you, I'm just gonna send the invite out.
Yeah.
As in, not the invite, the link to the
now
chat.
Now I'm gonna go back into just normal. Probably change. So has my voice changed?
Yeah, it's become more muffled.
Yeah, that's weird. Isn't it? Is it okay or is it
acceptable? It will do. I think what I'll do is I'll ask the stream how it sounds to them. One second.
Yeah, I mean, it wouldn't make a difference if it's my part or your part. It's just awesome. And I can't comment out on the screen, so I'll be like 2 minutes off.
Exactly, yeah.
So yeah, we'll just have to deal with this. Yeah.
Cool.
Busy man. Long time.
It has been a long time. I haven't seen you in person in years.
Last time I saw you in the flesh when you were around with like pre-baby.
Yes, that was pre-baby. Gosh, so that was at least pre-baby. 4 years ago. God damn.
I mean, I did go to one of those first fights.
Yeah, you might have seen me there. I missed the last couple of versus fightings as well, though. That's the thing. So I've not been consistent myself.
When was the versus fighting when
Say again?
When was the versus fighting when I got food poisoning?
Oh man. Where did you eat? Where did you eat from? You didn't go to Chaps, did you?
Yeah.
See, that's... Oh man. Fucking hell. That's why that place is closed down now.
You took me, Veggie, and everyone else to this church place, whatever it was.
Oh shit, okay, yeah, I know. Yeah, that place actually hasn't closed down yet. Oh man.
That place was sick.
It was like £10 and you get like a table full of food. It was just the insane amount of meat.
Because we were like, oh, let's just put in £10 each and then see what we get. And what did we get?
Horse meat, that's what we got.
Yeah, but horse meat, not the horse meat.
Alright, I think this is a lag test.
Oh, definitely. Hello. Right, so I'm thinking going into a lag test.
Yeah. Looks like Shaolin spin kicks are on point. So if that's what they're testing, they're all good. I didn't even know Marduk had a crouch grab.
And a what?
A crouch grab, you know, down 2 plus 4, 1 plus 3. What does it do? Is it like the launching grab?
No.
Just like a damage type one.
Show us the crouch grab.
Yeah, crouch grab. Oh, they can't hear us.
No, they can't hear us. That knee is so good.
Yeah. Well, what do you think of Marduk in this game?
Oh, he's good. Similar to the model game.
Yeah. I can't remember a game where Marduk hasn't been good, to be honest. T5, or maybe I guess he wasn't great. Yeah. Yep. So I think it grew into it, into its own. So I think at launch, I wasn't terribly impressed, I'll be honest. And so I kind of, you know, drifted off when Tag 2 came out. Completely stopped playing. And then when T7 came out, I thought, shit, this is even worse than Tag 2. So completely ignored it. But I think, you know, after a couple of balanced... There was no lay, you know, the character choice... And you know what it was? The new characters, I thought, were really uninspired. Lucky Chloe, yeah. Claudio, Katarina, I thought, wow, these are like, you know, appealing to the lowest common denominator characters. No offense to anybody who plays those characters. Exactly. And it's the kind of tools they had, you know, like far-reaching hop kicks. Yeah, it's kind of like, they were not classic Tekken characters in the sense where, you know, these characters have depth or they have a theme. They were just like general jack-of-all-trades characters with far-reaching hop kicks. Same with Shaheen. Man, does anybody even remember that Shaheen's in the game? That character, most uninspired, dry character. But you know what it was? Once FR came out and once they introduced some balance patches in the DLC. Exactly, yeah. With a couple of balance patches and you know, and the way people have evolved the meta and shown us like different characters, like, you know, Rang Chu winning, was it EVO or the World Tour? I can't remember now, the World Tour. And people exploring the different characters, I think that has made the game become a lot more interesting. The DLC obviously helps. I think they've made great choices with the DLC, especially second season DLC. Oh, what am I supposed to do? Kick you out and then reinvite you?
If you want to do it that way, then you can stay. If you have enough potion to do the battle, if the second go away, then that's fine, otherwise you can. I'm sure it's a fun potion now. But yeah, it's faster that way. It's more. So yeah, kick me and then reinvite.
Alright, I'll do that for the next one.
Can you only send me 5 invites so you don't have to send them each
That's
one.
A good shout. I'll do that. Right.
Mother. Raven. Speed.
Yeah, Batman Fresh has got a few characters. He's been using Raven mostly, I think.
Yeah, the third was there was no Raven last time. He didn't want to mirror that.
Who did he use last time? Well, we'll find out in a minute.
Find out in a minute. Well, memory's not what it used to be.
he's going with Marduk. Okay. I do enjoy watching Marduk. I just don't enjoy fighting him.
There's absolutely no surprise about his opponent picking Lily.
Yeah. His Lily is interesting. He's got some really good setups, especially on knockdown. He's got the kind of, you know, step over corpse setups, as they call them in Marvel, and catches you back turn. So hopefully we can see some of that.
What? Roots?
Yeah. That's what I was about to say, actually. I wonder if it works as well on Marta, because his body is so much longer. She should still be able to make it over with the hop, but we'll see.
Yeah, it's going to be good. Oh, there's going into the first match. Batman
Fresh,
electric to hold you back.
Very hard. Yeah. Oh, wow, he gets a bit of a jammy floor break. Capitalize on it, nice. Or big whiff on the low. So one thing I never see Lily players do, and I'd love to see more of, is on a big whiff, don't punish with hop kick, punish with Psycho Crusher. The damage difference is massive. down to before. You know, the stupid, massive, crushing launch. Yeah.
I mean, that's really probably not that good, but
yep.
I mean, it's a nice question, really high mode, but I don't think that's high
mode. Yeah, definitely.
All I need is one step in the back.
Yeah, if Lily uses that back turn. Yeah, if she uses it back turn poorly, my god, you can fuck her up for it. Oh wow, this could take the whole round.
That does take the whole round.
Oh my god.
Did you watch my match against Hassan?
No, I haven't seen it yet. No, no, no. It was just before this, wasn't it? But you won that, didn't you? 5-3.
I did indeed.
Very nice, very nice.
I think that was Hassan's first loss, wasn't it?
I was going to say, I bet you robbed him with Lay shenanigans that he didn't know about.
Oh, wait, you heard him.
It's all good, man. I was talking about this in the general chat the other day, and I was saying, look, it's all well and good to have a friendly environment of players that you get on with, that you talk with, and you share strats and stuff. But I think there's an element of due diligence being lost, where people are not doing some of the research that they need to be doing. If you're serious about winning, then you need to know how to punish it.
Tell you what, though, if you watch that match, I think it's much punished to do more than more knowledge. I don't think it's going to be much more.
Sure, yeah. It's a lot of it was.
I went super Saiyan on him, 5 matches in a row. I lost the first three convincingly.
Yeah.
And then instantly, you know, I said, you know, what the thing? You are insanely good.
I saw that in the chat. Yeah, his fundamentals are so good, man.
Insane. I mean, I felt like I'm being schooled here. I felt like my 12-year-old daughter.
You have to turn on the bullshit against him, because you try and play fundamentals against him, he fucks you up. So
every time I reach anything, electric. Any time you try to go over, too obvious, no. Kick over. Oh, it's nasty.
So I'm just going to send you a bunch of invites now. No, not yet. I'm playing Sin tonight, though. Yeah. No, because he's been waiting for a while, so I really should be playing him first. But I can play tomorrow, I can play, but I think we're better off playing Monday if you can, and I can do basically any day next week.
Yeah, I mean, any time, as long as it's after 8 o'clock and baby's going to bed, I'm fine. Except for Tuesday, because that's badminton night.
Yeah, that's fine.
I mean, we can make it. I would kind of prefer to get it out of the way. I'm not one to sit on my match inside on this.
I can do tomorrow. The only thing is, tomorrow in the evening, I'm not going to be about. In the daytime, so basically between... I'd say between... I definitely can't do it tonight. My wife will kill me. So I can do one of you tonight.
I see. Yeah, well, then do soon. I want to watch that. That'll satisfy my Tekken.
Cool.
Tomorrow though, after 8, if you're cool with that.
Yeah, tomorrow after 8, that should be... Well, the only thing is, I'm going to watch Captain Marvel tomorrow. So that I should be back. That's perfect, actually. So if we go early, to the earlier showing... I'll be back by about 8 or 9, so I think that'll work.
That's fine. I mean, any time after 8 is absolutely fine for me.
Right, we need to commentate this match now, because Rubes took the first match, and now Badman Fresh has switched to Feng. So his Feng is solid. I do like his Feng, so let's see how it goes.
I've got some tricky moves. I'm making sure I can back Temple Parry a lot. Round 1.
They nerfed it in the last patch. I mean, even though it's been nerfed and it has a bigger window that you can't block in.
Unlucky there for the temple hopper.
Oh, Liddy gets nice damage. Okay, that's punishable, and he does get a punish. Ah, the setups are coming out now. Back 10 shenanigans.
Both players shooting from long distance. Liddy didn't bounce forward, he's up forward, and really, really good move.
Yeah.
He's got a little very high low here.
Does have a mid mix-up, but you can fuzzy guard both options. Oh, gets clipped. He could have had a full combo there, but didn't recognize it. Oh man, get the big sweep. I feel like that's the kind of match this is going to be. Both players are going to bust out the big sweep lows. And there's one from Feng. What's the Oki? So... Oh, he slightly... He left a gap. He left a gap, and that's all he Liddy needed. Okay. Oh, man. Gets clipped. What a choice of move. I love it. Yep. Yep. Safe on block, and even plus if you can make it meaty. Okay. Gets another side step four. Do you remember size step 4 in T5, Seb?
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow. Just the big snakehead. Okay. A back Kenpo step needs to get, would get him out of this pressure, but you didn't think of it. Oh, he's going to get clipped by another low. Oh, there he is.
He didn't think he had it already on the first. The
opportunity and yep. Oh, wow. He goes for the double step. You actually can get a pickup off that stun, but I wonder if he knows about that. Good conversion. There's the hop over setup I was talking about. Oh wow! He just did the forward 3-4. Man gives no shits. Oh, he misses the big cycle crusher. That may have taken the round. Okay, yeah, really well-timed lows now. Rubes is kind of taking the bait on these little pokes. Oh, man, that's going to hurt. I love that, bro. This could be a... Oof, perfect. 7 golden letters.
So it goes to 1-1, then.
It has indeed.
So all set, nearly all set, have been 5-4, 5-3, really, really well matched up players.
Yeah, there's been... Yeah, I think so, yeah. I mean, I really agonized over these. Especially Division 2, I was like, this is a tough division to get the balance right, but it's actually turned out to be the tightest division, so I'm pretty happy with how it's gone. Yeah, absolutely, and great storylines as well, and some good banter in the chat.
Division 2 is the division that has played
the longest. No, Division 3 actually is. Division 3 has. It started off playing the least amount, and then they just went crazy and played. Some people have played 5 or 6 sets in that division.
So going into the third match.
It feels like Badman Fresh has kind of adjusted to the rhythm of Rubes. So he's picking those spots where he knows Rubes will try and press buttons because he wants to take the momentum back, and then he's catching him with a crushing low.
Rubes is a bit nervous though. Rubes is a bit nervous at the moment. I don't think
he needs to slow down, calm down, wait for those lows and punish them.
Yeah. So he's had some opportunities where he can convert really quite easily with Liddy and
not gone for them. He's done the wrong move at that point.
Mm.
And he's paid for it. He's paid for it in this match. So let's see if he can adapt to that thing. Get back into the rhythm. And we're on last day on Earth, the Negan stage.
Oh God, I apologize in advance because I haven't changed the music on this on this level yet. So it's got the awful default music.
Yeah,
I like the actual stage, so if you watch Walking Dead, you know, it's a great pull of great references.
Oh yeah, it's a really long argument everywhere.
man, it sounds like a Mortal Kombat OST. And that's not a good thing. Okay, so Rube's trying to start his offense again. Playing a bit more. See, he still did the same thing though. He tried to take his turn back with jabs. And if Badman Fresh had stuck to his old game plan of sidestep boring at the right time, he would have eaten that launch. He needs to make some slight adjustments here. There's a wall run coming. Oh, he didn't do it. Okay. I would have wall run. Yeah. Yeah, that could be a big. That could be the change you needed. Okay. Slightly risky going for the punchable string, but it hits, it hits. Oh wow, well played top dish. Damage. Oh, he gets the conversion off the flip. 4-4-3. Wow, big damage off these pokes.
Very good.
Oh man, that should have been the end. I knew. That is unfortunate. That is unfortunate. He should have waited it out, but. It had some great properties on it, you know, the homing, the how low she gets to the ground, but a snake edge is a snake edge in the end. Yeah.
Round 4. Fight. No, that was a quick thing. I just some loot and then taking the third round. I think
I know, yeah, it was a very quick round.
Blink and you missed it.
Oh, that was a very slick sidestep there. He gets hit by the big headbutt. That's got to be the most satisfying Feng move to land. Caught sucker forward 1+2. When it hits counter hit, you just get slapped into the floor. Oh wow, great punish. This is going to get to the wall. Oh, he should have pushed for the wall. He would have got to it. Okay, doesn't matter. He gets the relaunch. What do I know? Oh, a series of very strange events there. He goes for a 1+2, and then the snake edge was just slightly out of range. He would have eaten it. He was not blocking. But he takes the round. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's good backdash and all that. I can't believe it. But 2-1, Batman.
By the way, Uzi.
Hmm?
My missus hates you.
Why would I do? Oh, because the league.
League and more than anything else, getting into comment. Oh my god.
But isn't it really motivating? Doesn't it? It could just kind of make you want to. Because I was.
Commenting. I didn't realize how funny it is commenting.
It is. It is really fun.
I'm sort of afraid of it. I don't have anything to say, but it's quite naturally fun. I'm not saying I'm that good at it, but you know, at least people don't complain.
It helps having that kind of wealth of knowledge to fall back on. A lot easier to kind of just talk about. I mean, especially, two things really help, I think. If you have good chemistry with the other guy, and if you know about what you're actually watching, if you have those two things, it's going to be an enjoyable commentating session.
Yeah. You're absolutely right. It's called synergy, isn't it?
Yep. And if obviously it helps that if it's a hype match, you know, this is quite closely contested. Even that went to the last round. The rounds themselves are not that close. They're quite one-sided either way. But the matches themselves are going down to the wire.
It's on the edge of a blade. We're absolutely cut grass with how little this seems contested. So, still the same characters. We've not seen any change so far. Hardman Fresh sticking with Feng and Rubes with Lily. Does Rubes have a pocket
He does have another character. I can't remember who it was. He's got one or two other ones. I can't remember who they were. But for this league, I'm pretty sure he's been running Lily all the way through.
So for this league, he's become a bit of a one-trick pony then.
So Lily's kind of interesting. Do you remember that tournament last year that where Nii busted out Lily against Qdans? I don't know if you catch that, but he lost to Qdans early in that tournament using Lily, and then in the finals he did it again because he had faith in it, and he completely steamrolled him. And I don't know what property he saw in Lily, because there was nothing in that match to suggest, you know, Nii was just doing Nii stuff. There's nothing in that to suggest that he had some kind of reason to pick Lily. Yep.
But then again, one of our Archman asked.
Oh man, that guy. Yeah, everybody had written Kazumi off, and then he comes out doing the exact same Kazumi shit from day one, but just executing it perfectly. And just takes everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh wow.
Or Rage Drive.
There's a counter Rage Art coming. Yeah. Or Rage Drive. Oh, great step.
Now, I feel that sometimes, when you're just knowing life, it's a little bit scary. If you know that someone has a back door now, just be entered and see if the back door doesn't fit.
Yeah, it could turn it all around. What do you have to lose? One hit either way is going to kill you.
Fight. Yeah, you might just lose the trick, but it's instead of him going back there, but it's your back there. You've got a full day of that.
Exactly. Oh, he goes for a nice high damage combo there. He did the delay forward.
I was expecting the back turn throw there, but so far, he wasn't actually very good.
Yep. Okay, so he brought out the quarter circle forward one finally with Feng. Now, that is such a great move, and I'd love him to use more of that in this set.
It looks like he's fine.
Yeah.
That was a horror moment. Both staying in mid range.
Both of them trying to create whips with those five walls. Okay.
That's the rage effect.
Oh, what a move choice! Wow! That was brilliant. Oh, he didn't quite get to the wall, but who gives a shit? Goes for the quarter circle 3 plus 4.
Fantastic. Good choice there from Lily.
Good, yeah. Excellent decision making. Right, basically took the round.
Damage.
Very tight set.
Yeah, once again, from your choices for divisions.
Thank you.
I'll be honest with you, yeah, I did not think that I belonged in.
Ah, see, that's why I didn't ask each individual player where they think they belong. Everybody would have said Division 3 or 2 or some shit.
Yes.
But it's obviously correct because you've won, I think, more sets than you've lost.
I haven't. So far, you could make it either.
We'll see. We'll see. I hope you have Negan practice, is all I'm going to say.
Are you kidding me? You're not picking all Negan, you're picking Negan.
No, I'm picking Negan.
Oh,
I'm going to rob you with the DLC character. If I Negan loses, I'm going to pick Noctis or some stupid shit like that.
I love Noctis. Noctis is great. I don't mind Noctis. You get another one. So, it's 3-2.
2-2, isn't it? 2-2. Yeah,
yeah. Streaming,
it's looking like Hassan is trying to set up some actually after round as well.
Oh, today?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Oh, that's going to be a great one.
You going to stream it officially?
Probably not, because if I don't spend some time with my wife right after this, I will.
Before they disappear, by the way.
I've downloaded them all, so I just need to re-upload them.
Yeah, from mine as well, or?
Yep, I've got them off you as well, yep.
Oh, excellent, because we don't want to be losing any of this shit.
No, I need to basically. I've downloaded them all now, so I just need to do a bit of post processing. You know, add the intro logos, the overlays,
yeah.
And then I'm going to re-upload them to both the Twitch and the YouTube.
Sounds good.
Alright, so going to the Twitch match in this deck, and this goes to Twitch still all the way from character, and looking at the very close match.
Yeah, really nice adjustment by Rubes in that last round. In particular, the move choices were just excellent. Oh, and now Badman Fresh going back to the well with that 5-4, which is hit every time he's landed it in range. Nicely placed for that 3-2. Oh, wow, punishes with the 5-4. Straight into Rage Art. Yeah. Okay, nice whiff punish.
That was it. The down back.
Mm.
Perfect. Why? The down 4-4.
Yeah, the down 4-3. The back turn 2 hit spring.
Yeah, that's very good.
That's the one I was talking about. Yeah, but it seems like he's either scouted it. I know these guys have played many times before. So, oh man, he eats the snake edge. And he gets the wall, takes the frame advantage, and doesn't break the normal throw, interesting. Doesn't duck the down back 1-4. Oh, delayed string on that. Very nice.
Final round.
Oh, wow. Oh, doesn't get the full launch on that. At the wall. Goes for the stomp. Oh, and wow. Low parries the dick jab. This is a clean round. Yep. Wow, returns a favor from that perfect from before. Very momentum-based rounds these are.
These are long, long matches.
Mm.
If anyone had any pounds down in the machine,
pick them up right now and make them. Oh, I remember when when that the arcade in Notts got T6 for the first time, the amount of, I made more visits to Nottingham.
No, that one. When he's got T5 for the first time.
Oh no. Yeah.
That's when the Brian T5.
Jesus Christ, Brian and T5. If you got to the wall, and you always got to the wall, you were just done.
Guaranteed.
Yeah, that was the most messed up shit, man. It's like, it was so inevitable. It didn't... That's what made it hurt, right? That you knew it was coming, and there was nothing... Unless it was off-axis, there was nothing you could do about it. And then you get the relaunch into the 1-2-1 again.
And then you'll be on a disadvantage. You get up to whatever else is coming.
Yeah. The round is basically done. It was basically a death on pose. I love that game.
Yeah, because that Tekken 5 is
Tekken 6 without the shenanigans.
Yeah.
I think they really built a lot of that. Tekken 6 is good as well.
Yeah, oh, he switched.
And I'll be honest with you, it's the first time I see Batman versus Raven all together.
So I'd say Raven is his strongest character. But let's see if we can, you know, it's all about styles and characters, so it may just not be effective against Woobs' Lily. We'll have to see how it goes.
As you said, these guys have played each other many, many times before, so maybe he felt like he didn't know the same as what he played.
Oh, nice, look on it. Okay, gets to the wall. Oh, but doesn't get the big wall damage. Oh, what a setup! What? Yeah, these are some tried and tested online setups. It's a very different kind of pace, isn't it? And a very different problem to deal with. Wow, he baited out a jab and then went for a wall climbing punish. Interesting. Didn't quite space it out right at the wall. Yeah. There is a mid, yeah. They're all interruptible though. Yeah. Jabs, but then obviously if you jab, the low one will crush you. I think so, actually. I think you can interrupt the mid and the low with the crouch jabbing or go under the high. I haven't tested it, but there's a massive gap between them. Oh, wow, that was some Matrix shit. Backflips over the low. Yeah, absolutely. Wow, once Batman first gets started though, very difficult to stop that momentum. Goes for the double kick. Nope, he's going for the full wall carry combo, but it was a side slap. Oh, nice backdash and whiff punish. Very good. Oh, eats a counter hit. What's the wall damage here? Didn't quite get it. Might lose the round here if he's not careful. Doesn't break the 1 plus 2. We've seen that set before. Oh wow, gambled it all on the cycle crusher. Pays off. Okay, Batman Fresh not out of it. Wants to get his own game plan going, not ducking these for a quarter circle for 3+4s. And one catches him in the air. Here comes another one, 1+2 break. Nope, goes for a stomp, even better. Wow, great adjustment.
That's 4-2, right?
Yep.
Strong, really. If I was a better man, I would have better had my impression if you're not even better.
I knew it would be tight, but I would have probably said Batman Fresh, but with it being very close. But it looks like he's going to run away with it. Take the next one, it's 5-2.
Yeah, it takes the next one, it's 5-2 indeed.
that was our instrument
that
potentially the last match.
Will he switch? See, I don't think he should have changed off Feng. His Feng wasn't doing badly. The only thing that happened in that last match with Feng was Rubes made a couple of really, really good...
I think the game plan was always, if I lose two matches in a row, I lose one character. Like, I need to confuse him.
But I think you have to be fluid, right? You have to be organic. And if something is working, then you have to be in the moment and say, look, I'm going to push with this game plan because it's working. I had a bad round. And that's what it is. It's recognizing when you have an anomalous bad round, but your overall game plan has been solid and is working. I think it's really easy to get disheartened when you get hit by a couple of crazy reads. But you need to be able to have some conviction in your original game plan and make that adjustment and say, look, the Feng is working really well. In that round, he lost. Rubes busted out a down back three high crush and then dropped a wall combo and cancelled it into court circle 4 3+4 to catch a sidewalk. I mean, those are rare instances. They don't really indicate that your entire character or game plan is failing. So I think I would have liked him to stick to the thing, but we'll see. Maybe he'll go back, maybe he'll stay. We'll see what happens.
Yeah,
Could be.
Especially since he had one match before final match. So he had one match to try out Raven before decision time. But I think he'll go back to Feng now.
Oh wow, he's sticking it out with the Raven. Interesting.
He's sticking it out with the Raven. So 4-2 to Rubes.
It's not like his Raven did badly either.
No. They were 3-2 to rounds anyway, so
yeah, exactly.
You know, running away with it. It was just a bit unlucky, and he calculated the wall carry a little bit too wrong. Went for
that
wrong.
That was the difference maker in a couple of rounds, wasn't it? He didn't quite get the carry right, and he didn't quite get the wall combo right, and that damage that he missed out on cost him.
Yeah, once while Rubes recognized that he didn't get the wall carry.
Like that was perfectly spaced to the wall and he did the right combo. Oh, nice step. Oh, he gets the tail fin. Rubes has get backed away somewhat and given him the space to get away from the wall. I think I would have liked him to press forward and keep the wall advantage. Whenever he's had bad man pressures back to the wall, he has closed out the round quickly. In the neutral, it seems a lot more even. Oh wow, what a great back! What a low parry, so clutch. That could be really mentally guard breaking. Oh, nice step. And that's where Raven's kind of big advantage comes, that big wall damage. Oh, so he tried to crush that low, but he didn't leave the ground fast enough. Right, that's exactly right, because she kind of resplashed you with the slide input 3-4. Oh my god, Harada!
That's exactly what we were talking about.
Exactly, yeah. No other combo or character could have done that much damage and closed out the round. Oh, he's gone for the double 3-4. Oh, again, he doesn't quite space it out and he loses out on loads of damage, but keep the pressure up and he's got another splat. This is looking like a clean round. Okay, good interrupt. Oh, he actually got a relaunch there. Teleport shenanigans are coming out now. He's just going for these sliding put 3-4s. That back sway is coming really well. Okay, trying to get the momentum back with little pokes. Nice little sidestep there. Okay, rage drive, take the frame advantage. Not able to do much with it. Oh my god, he brought it all back. One more hit, close it up. Ah, the backsway whiffed. What? It went clean through him. What? Wow, great step.
One of the most intense slow-mos ever.
God, I thought it was done because down fours have great tracking normally.
Yeah, normally it does. Woo! But my first day here. 3-4.
Insane. Insane match.
That was a strong statement there, wasn't it?
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, I wonder how that will affect Rubes, because he almost brought that back, and it's very easy to see that and think you got robbed. You got robbed by the game, and for that mentally to guard break you, it's really important now for him to stay focused and immediately put it out of his mind. That's easier said than done. We've all had matches and rounds, you know, in tournament, online, whatever, where we see something and we just shake our heads and we're like, what the fuck just happened to me? It's so difficult to put that out of your mind and refocus. But that's what he needs to do.
I think Rube's got the mental alertness, mental stability, but not really good about that.
I think so, and you know, we've seen plenty of examples again, where he seems to be really in the moment, really focused.
I'll be neutral.
Yeah.
made the best out of it.
You should see the look that you have from my Mrs. It's so
funny.
Mine just came into the room, saw I was on commentary, swore at me and left.
What's that?
My wife just came into the room, saw that I was on commentary, then swore at me and left.
Yeah, mine didn't swear at me, but the look that she gave me could might as well be just the same. If anyone could swear with their eyes, it's my dealer.
Okay, let's see the adjustment now. Man, can you imagine the damage Raven would get on the stage with a balcony break as well? Whiff on the cartwheel. No big punish, but it will deter him, I guess, from doing that willy-nilly. Okay, big hit. No guaranteed damage afterwards. Oh, what was that? That was not the conversion he wanted. Feeling the pressure now, I think. Oh, he got clipped. He slightly mistimed that. Well, it wasn't a mistimed backsway. It's just that Rubes picked a move that wouldn't hit until later. It was a slower move. He caught him on the way back in on the backsway. Counter hit, big damage. I don't think so. I think he saw it was off axis and tried to go for a stomp for the Oki. And when it whiffed, he just mashed the fastest back turn with the ad. Okay, big launch. That is a nice combo. Three knees in the combo, but doesn't get to the wall. Oh, he shouldn't have done the teleport and he would have had the big wall combo. It doesn't matter. He closes it out. Oh wow, follows him with the sidestep. Nice choice. Two down four threes in a row. Something like plus four or five on block. Great move. Yeah, gonna go for the cartwheel and the setup afterwards, and of course a low V-splats. He can balcony break, he does. Can he get tailspin here as well? Oh, he doesn't. No, oh, this is it. It's over. Oh wow, great set, well done to Rube. I feel like in that last match, Badman Fresh kind of he got jittery. He wasn't playing as effectively as he was in the previous match. He let chances go. And the big difference maker was, I think he wasn't maximizing on damage when he got the big launches.
He wasn't 100% clear on which move to take all the way to the wall, and still leaving the setup on the wall.
Yeah.
And when I really got frustrated, but she didn't fit. So try to continue the juggle like it should have been, even though it didn't get with empty. That's what happens when small errors head down in your favor.
Yeah, great set though. So I think that's it. We're going to close it out. We've got a couple more potentially matches tonight. I won't be able to stream them, unfortunately. But Seb, if you can or if somebody else can, that'd be good. Say again. I've got that, but I don't want to stream and play it at the same time because my connection's not good enough for that.
My internet is not good.
My internet is ass, so unfortunately. It's one or the other, playing or streaming.
I'll definitely stream as well.
Awesome. Cool, I will catch you soon then.
You need someone on comments to follow on. You need someone on your side.
Oh, come on, bro. How are you not supporting me in that one? Nottingham massive, eh? I see how it is.
Let's go when I saw each other off the ass.
I'm coming to your house now. I'll play the set at your house.
Yeah, you're getting in the car coming in now.
I'm on my way.
Yeah, you'll be here in about 10 minutes then. You're in Birmingham. What, 330 miles an hour down the road?
I'm calmed down in my old age.
I remember you.
Right, GG's.
You got me a car, you crazy.
I'll catch you soon, sir. Peace out.
Later.
Later.